Welcome back to our Pointing to the Promise online Bible study. We're beginning week two, and we have some special things in store for you. If you're just joining us, my name is Wendy Blight, and I'm on staff with the online Bible studies team. This week, we're focusing on the word respond. God desires that when we read his word and the gospel message, we don't just hear the good news, but we respond to what we're learning. Kayla, how can we respond to what we're learning when adding one more thing on our plate seems impossible? And what can we do to respond this week?
Well, first to our United States friends, happy Thanksgiving week. But I just wanted to say, no matter where you are, I love knowing that God is preparing the biggest and best homecoming feast ever for us one day. And I can't wait to sit at that table next to you. So today, Wendy asked two great questions, and I want to address each of them individually because I think they are both super important. And the first question is, how can we respond to what we're learning when adding one more thing to our day seems impossible right now? And I just want to share something with you quickly that has really helped me, and it's this idea of all or nothing thinking. All or nothing thinking says that I have to do all of it exactly right, or I'm going to do none of it. And I am really bad at this. So for example, my ideal goal is to work out for 30 minutes in the morning. You know, but some mornings I wake up late or something comes up and I can't do 30 minutes in the morning. So I tend to get frustrated and just be like, I ruined my entire workout today, it's over. But instead, what I'm learning to say is, okay, I don't have 30 minutes right now. Do you know what? I have 10 minutes. And 10 minutes is better than no minutes. It doesn't have to be all or nothing. And I want to tell you, you know, the same is true for this study. If you miss a day, it's okay. Like, don't throw the whole study out. If your week is super busy, you know, maybe you just focus on one day, or maybe you just read the verses for each day, because I promise even that little bit can make a big difference. So in answer to the first question, I have found it really helpful to be aware of my all or nothing thinking. The second question Wendy asked was, how will we respond to what we're learning this week? And I love this question because I want you to know, like, there is no one way to respond. And this week we're gonna see that. We're gonna see Mary respond to the news of baby Jesus with amazing faith. Like, you know, truly this news had to have rocked her world. She wasn't married and she was going to have a baby. People were gonna talk, but she had faith that God would take care of it. We're also gonna see Joseph. Interesting fact, did you know that there is not a single quotation in our Bibles from Joseph? We have no words from him. So I just kind of think of him as being like maybe the strong and silent type. But Joseph responded in the way he was created, in quiet obedience. This week, we're also gonna see, get this, the embryo of John the Baptist responding to Jesus by leaping for joy in the womb. There's going to be some dancing going on. And we're gonna see his mother, Elizabeth, respond by crying out blessings. See, friends, there's not just one way to respond this week. God made you unique. Your personality and preferences were by design. And Jesus just wants you to respond, and to respond in your own unique way. So maybe this week you crank up a worship song and you sing it at the top of your lungs. Maybe you dance. Maybe you take 60 seconds to just sit in a quiet place. Maybe you respond by being obedient to something he's asked you to do. You know, or maybe you just keep reminding yourself this week, God's going to take care of it. I can't tell you how you need to respond, but I know it doesn't have to be some big planned event that you need to add to your already crazy calendar. Response is about the heart, and it's about Jesus. And all it takes is a minute to say, God, thank you. So that is your moment of reflection for this week. Go find your own unique way to tell God thank you.
I have a feeling this week's moment of reflection will be one of my favorites. Kayla, I'm grateful you invited us to respond in our own way because we are all different. We can do what works for us and helps us connect best with Jesus. And for our friends in the United States, we wish you a blessed and joy-filled Thanksgiving. Remember, when you know the truth of God's word and live it out, it changes everything.